The main thing is what Ehrlich would have said was a magic bullet idea. You want as much action on the bug and as little on the host. That's obvious, isn't it?
Yeah.
But you've got to balance that as an equation, maybe subconsciously with every patient, really.
Yes.
Are they allergic to the drug? Have they got kidney failure? What's their age? What's their size?
Yeah,
the stuff which we do kind of semi-automatically, but maybe not quite consciously enough in many cases.
Yeah.
And then when you know the bug, relatively easy, you know which drugs, or you should, or you can look them up in a book, which drugs are appropriate. And then you put the rest of the stuff together and say, do that in that dose.
Yes.
And I think that all sounds so incredibly elementary. But most of the terrible mistakes I've seen have been because people don't do that quite at that level. They say, I want a drug for septicemia or for pneumonia. There's no such thing. I mean, antibiotics don't resolve inflammatory exudation in the lung. They don't stop the inflammatory cascade, which is killing somebody with septicemia. All they do, not quite all, but for practical purposes, all they do is to inhibit or kill bugs.
Mm.
And unless you go to the actual nub of the thing to say, which bugs do I want to kill because I know or I think it's this one, but it could be that one. And then again, it could be that one, but it doesn't matter because the patient will get better anyway. It could be that one, but although it's only 1%, it'll kill him. So again, there's that equation of the importance of the possible pathogens. I mean, it sounds so incredibly banal, but I really think that most mistakes are because people don't go through that elementary ground of saying, which bug? Has the patient got an infection?
Mm.
What's the cause of it? Do I know? Do I think? How shall I get about that thing? And then what's this equation between the drugs and the body? I suppose actually the truth is we should be doing this with every medicine, shouldn't we?
But
we don't all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think a big part of my life was trying to teach people about that.
It's almost about you're trying to teach a process of clinical reasoning. Is that?
Yes, actually, that's right. When I started reading a bit, which I didn't really understand about, rational diagnosis and decision theory in medicine, which was a bit beyond me, but I realised in a dim sort of way that actually that's what you're doing.
Yeah.
It's decision theory. And I don't mean intuitively in the sense that it's by some mystical, magical insight which I've got. What I mean is that you're subconsciously or consciously balancing up these factors as well as you can in the light of what you know.
Yes.
Exactly that.
And do you feel that that you've been able to get that message across, or do you think it's slipping away from us?
No, I think the mistakes are just as crass as they always were, but I've probably got it across to some people some of the time, including myself. Now, I don't know really. There's all the pharmacokinetics of the drug. I mean, without joking about it, we still do see terrible things about using drugs which people don't need.
Mm-hmm.
I used to have a slide when I was teaching at the London School of Hygiene.
Mm.
And the end of it said, about antibiotics, most people who get them don't need them. Most people who need them don't get them, which is, I'm afraid, the case in the world.
Mm.
But no, I wouldn't say it was completely futile. No, I wouldn't say that. But I'd say it was still a pretty hard thing to follow. Probably the biggest influence has been the influence mainly in general practice to say, surely not everyone needs drugs all the time.
Yeah.
And the fact that that's spread to patients with their more anti-doctor, anti-medicine, anti-this horrible poison.
Yes.
Because in my early years of this specialty, I would give lectures to, forgive me, GPs.
Yes.
I make some very modest remark about maybe you could be a bit more restrictive about in this particular situation of this mild sore throat. And they'd practically attack me. They'd say, what, not give an antibiotic?
Yeah.
And practically drive me out of the room.
Yeah.
Years later, it was the other way around.
Yes.
And patients too. Not quite so. But let's face it, most people want some drug, don't they, when they come to see us.